Yesterday was Boxing Day, and what a Boxing Day. Of course, nobody was expecting to beat the record of 63, with 66 goals scored in one match day. That's an average of 6.6 goals per game. Well, yesterday during United Aston Villa, they didn't score 6.6 or even more, but they scored 5. And these 5 were enough to transmit us a fantastic, beautiful football game. We were all waiting for that game. A game that saw a fantastic comeback, United winning over Aston Villa, but also a miracle, because we know it. During Boxing Day, some miracles are happening. Yesterday, we assisted to a miracle, the first goal in Premier League of Rasmus Højlund. We'll speak about that miracle, but also other miracles in a second of Premier League, and of course about the other leagues, La Liga. At the moment, they are not playing games because it's a winter break, but some players are doing some activities like Bellingham, that is walking randomly in Gran Via, the main street of Madrid, while on the other side of Spain, in Catalonia, there are planes that are landing. We're speaking about Vitor Roque, that is receiving not only a lot of pressure from Xavi, but also a lot of pressure with a new shirt, with a new number. I will reveal you the number in a second. And in Italy, they are also speaking about a young kid that is receiving pressure, Kenan Yildiz, linked to a legend of the game, Alessandro Del Piero. Put a maximum of like on today's video, because we will speak about all of that. My name is Giuseppe, and together we will cover football. Thank you for sharing the channel with all your families and friends that are loving football as much as you do, as much as I do. We'll go back and we'll go through all the different leagues, starting with Premier League, because yesterday, I tell you, I'm not particularly a United fan, but yesterday I enjoyed seeing them winning, because I'm an 80s kid, a 90s kid, and I remember my team, Juventus, playing against United, these big duels in Champions League that were just fantastic. I was looking up at Alex Ferguson team, and yesterday they are far away to go back to the 90s, because it's just one win, but at least I saw that grinta, like you say in Italian, that will of winning, and that's what the United fans were asking for and from their players, showing us that you want to win, which they did, especially in that second half, because the comeback was just incredible, and not only the way of playing, but also one man that yesterday, he did a fantastic miracle. We are speaking about Rasmus Højlund that finished on all the British media. Daily Express Sport is speaking about Red Roar. Why? Because Rasmus Højlund yesterday, he was roaring like a lion after giving the 3 points to his team. Højlund steals a stunning comeback victory from United over Aston Villa to take heat off from Den Haag. There is It's All Kicking Off that is telling you, ho, ho, Højlund, beautiful title, referring to the period that we are in at the moment. We are during Christmas period, and Ho Ho Højlund is beautiful. It's beautiful, like the wishes that I want to share with you. Wish you the best. Wish you a merry, merry Christmas, my friends. Mirror Sport is continuing, of course, with Højlund on the first pages, with Winter Wonderlund, beautiful title here. And then Højlund fling for Star Sport. Well, if we spoke a lot about Højlund, and totally deservedly, because yesterday he scored a beautiful goal and he was nearly in tears to finally finding the net in Premier League, there is another guy that didn't finish on the first pages, but he totally deserved it as well. We're speaking about Garnacho, young kid, 19 years old, that yesterday did a fantastic performance. Not only the brace, because he showed actually United that they were able to come back from a 2-0 at halftime, 2-1, 2-2, giving hopes for a victory, for a comeback, but also the performance, playing on the right side of the field. What a performance, applauded by everyone. And there are even some people that are saying, hey, I'm old enough, I watched the very first Cristiano Ronaldo that started to play on the right side. Is that Argentinian guy that is looking up a lot to Cristiano, maybe finding his final position there on the right side where Cristiano started? Could be. Probably a bit exaggerated. But anyway, Sport is speaking about something else, about a new era. United's new era starts with a bang, because it was a bang yesterday. And I don't know if they did it for themselves, if they did it individually for the coach, if they did it for the supporters, or maybe for their new owners, or maybe for Radcliffe, I don't know. But they did it, and it was a bang. And on the other side, you can see that Radcliffe, he wanted to answer and to promise something to the United fans, telling them, we will transform United with fans' help. And I hope, I really hope that he's able to do it, because I think that United in the last few years, maybe the last 10 years, they suffered a lot. They need a bit of joy again. Anyway, do we believe in miracles? Yes, we believe. And there is one man that is also believing in them, and it is Patrice Evra. And he's probably believing more than you, more than me. Why? Because yesterday, while nobody was thinking of a comeback of United at halftime, he said, if United, they continue to play like they do now, of course, paying attention to the set pieces, well, I believe they can come back and I believe they can win 3-2. It happened. The miracle happened. And it was not the only miracle, because in Premier League we saw other miracles, like, for example, Liverpool that didn't concede first yesterday in their 2-0 victory. Another miracle during Newcastle against Nottingham Forest, the first game or the second game, the first victory of Nuno Espirito Santo, where we saw a miracle. We saw a hat-trick from Chris Wood against his old team Newcastle. Beautiful hat-trick yesterday, I have to say, because I watched the game. What a disaster defense of Newcastle. If they want to do better, they will have to really pay attention about how they are defending, because it was a shame. It was a disaster. And it's not a coincidence that they are already losing 6 games out of their last all competition games played. A total disaster. They have to come back, the Newcastle of the black and white, because at the moment it's not working at all. Nuno Espirito Santo yesterday, he was really incarnating that Christmas vibe. Why? Because he didn't want to take too much credit. He said, I'm just here, I just arrived, I didn't have time to work a lot with the kids, and we already played 2 games. Well, I want to share the credits with Steve Cooper, ex-coach of Nottingham Forest that has been dismissed, because he did fantastically well. I want to praise him. Beautiful. That's really the way to enter a new club. Well, there is another miracle before going to the other leagues. In Premier League, we are speaking about Bournemouth, that is continuing to win, to win, to win, to have positive results after positive result after positive result. 2-0 against Newcastle. They won 3-1. They did 2-2 against Aston Villa. 2-0 against Crystal Palace. They won 3-0 against United. 3-2 a few days ago against Nottingham Forest. And then yesterday, 3-0 win over Fulham. Beautiful. Not enough yet to enter that top 6, but if they continue like that, nobody will stop them. They will arrive in that top 6. A top 6 that at the moment sees Liverpool being first with 42. Aston Villa was not able to reach them because they lost yesterday. Arsenal has the possibility to go over to take the lead again with 43. We are waiting for the games of Spurs, Tottenham. We are waiting for Manchester City that will play today. We are also waiting for Chelsea. Chelsea that will also need a miracle if they want to go back to victory. Or maybe to maybe see one day again the top 6, which they were not able to see last year. Well, there is a man from Manchester City that will probably play today after winning everything, after the Blues being there on top of the world, after their fantastic win 4-0 a few days ago. Well, they are back in Premier League. And yesterday, Bernardo Silva, he said some important things. Do I come back to Benfica? Who knows? Maybe one day, but only after my contract stops with Manchester City. But what there was something that was quite worrying, or at least for the Blue fans, for the City fans, it's the fact that he said it will be difficult to repeat 2023, which all the Citizen fans are conscious about. But if you hear the words of Pep Guardiola, if you listen to the mood of the team, of the players, looks like they won so much and everything, and that they don't believe it's again possible to do it. They are at the moment out of the top 4. They can do it, of course. They will maybe try to compete for the Premier League title, but it will be tough, and they will have to convince themselves that it's possible to do better as 2023. Otherwise, they give up. They will have to put themselves new challenges, like Griezmann, because now we go to La Liga, that was able to put himself new challenges after the journey at Barcelona, coming back to Atletico Madrid and doing fantastic things. He's saying it in Atletico Madrid, I feel myself good. I feel good. I feel grande here. I feel fantastic, and I don't want to leave. Maybe one day in MLS, but not now. I have a lot of things to do with Atletico Madrid. Well, us is also speaking about another big game of yesterday. We are speaking about Cristiano Ronaldo against Benzema in the Saudi League, with Cristiano Ronaldo winning 5-2. Why am I mentioning it? Because Cristiano Ronaldo, scoring 2 penalties yesterday, was able to reach 53 goals in 2023, which means that it's at the moment leading the top scorers over Harry Kane, over Kylian Mbappé, over Erling Haaland. Fantastic, beautiful achievement for Cristiano Ronaldo. Well, while we don't speak a lot about Atletico, about Real Madrid, with Bellingham that is just walking in the street in Gran Via, taking selfies with people after coming back from London yesterday, where he watched actually his young brother Kobe playing a game. Well, in the meanwhile, you have other players that are arriving to Spain. We are speaking about Vitor Roque, Mundo Deportivo. Vitor Roque entusiasma. The Barcelona fan, the Blaugrana, they are really with a lot of enthusiasm waiting for that kid that is arriving, and they can't wait to see him playing. Yes, he is the right signing that has been voted by the Barcelona fan. I will not comment too much about that first page, that front page of Mundo Deportivo. I understand, it's holidays. The papers are not working with full power at the moment. The graphic people are gone, but what a disaster first page. Anyway, I prefer that picture of Vitor Roque already with the Barcelona jacket. And when I told you that he's receiving a lot of pressure, well, look at the number that he will wear, the number 19. And for the Barcelona fan, they will all remember who was wearing the 19 in his first appearances with Barcelona. We are speaking about Lionel Messi. Speaking about kids, speaking about prospects, about potential, about the future, well, Paris Saint-Germain, they don't wait. They also want to be part of it, and they go for Gabriel Moscardo, a Brazilian player that will arrive to Paris Saint-Germain in the next few days, a player from 18, defensive midfielder that you really have to pay attention and monitor. They are continuing with the renewal of Paris Saint-Germain, a midfield made of kids, but what kids, they are really fantastic. Well, going to Serie A, in a few seconds we were speaking about kids, about Kenan Yildiz. But first of all, let's speak about Corriere dello Sport. He's speaking about the overhaul of Napoli. They want to change everything. After changing the coach, well, the position in the ranking of Serie A for Napoli is difficult, and they want to reinforce themselves immediately, looking for players like Itakura, but also Dragujin, Demiral, also Fofana, that went to Saudi Arabia. After 6 months, he could potentially come back to Europe, but they are targeting another player. Because it's true, they already sold Elmas to Leipzig, and they don't want to wait, knowing that Inter is about to find an agreement with Zielinski for next year. Well, they go full power with the money, with 25 million euro, convincing Udinese for Samardžić. Samardžić, young Serbian player that has so much potential. If they are able to seal the deal, I can tell you that he will do wonders, and he will help Napoli even more in their midfield. What is Inter answering? Well, Buchanan from Bruges going back for the right side, and they are going with Zielinski for next year. Will the finalist of the Champions League reinforce themselves even more during the winter? We don't know. On the other side, there is Roma that wants to reinforce themselves, going to Bundesliga, not to take a German player, but an Italian one. We are speaking about Leonardo Bonucci, that is about to find an agreement with Roma, with the team of Jose Mourinho, that one day said he's a professor. He could be a professor at Harvard to teach the defense. Well, they can be united for the very first time at Roma, Leonardo Bonucci, Jose Mourinho. Another defender that is now the defender of the Bianconeri is Bremer, and he doesn't want to leave. He doesn't want to go yet to Premier League or to another league. He wants to stay with the black and whites, and he wants to do it until 2028, because today probably they will announce his renewal after only 1 year being in with the Vecchia Signora. But another player that is there, and I told you that we would speak about him, it's Kenan Yildiz. Kenan Yildiz has scored a fantastic goal that went viral everywhere against Frosinone. Kenan Yildiz is the next thing in Serie A. Everyone is speaking about him. Tuttosport, Alex Yildiz, Linea Calda, hotline between Alessandro Del Piero and Kenan Yildiz. Why? Because Alessandro Del Piero is already speaking with him, he's giving him tips, he's also congratulating him. He sees the potential of a kid. And it's not the only one, because his agent, in a double page interview in Tuttosport, said the guy, Kenan Yildiz, is a machine that has been built to win, and he wants to win everything. Big words. I told you today, the kids 17, 18, 19, they have a lot of pressure and we enjoy it because like Garnacho, like Hojlund, like Vitor Roque, like all these kind of kids, we love to see them on the pitch because they are able to transmit us so many joy. I hope you enjoyed the video as well. I hope I was, because I'm not a kid anymore, able to transmit you a lot of joy. My name is Giuseppe and together we covered football.